This is Combat Fitness. We're here today with David Walker and Chaney Haight. David Walker, two-time All-American. Chaney Haight, Olympic alternate. 2008 Greco-Roman wrestling. And today, we're going to be showing hand fights.
Okay, your technique of the day, we're just going to go over some hand fight stuff from your wrestling. Hand fighting is just, what it basically means is being able to take a guy's arms and hands off of myself, but at the same time, be able to hand fight, bring his head down, and work into my offense from a hand fight, basically grabbing his hands, again, posting his arms off and fighting his head. Just a couple tips as far as hand fighting goes while we're in our stance in wrestling, and this is applicable in freestyle, Greco, and collegiate. First thing I want to go over is just a head position as I get into my hand fight. It's not going to be ear to ear, which we see a lot of wrestlers go strictly ear to ear. I like to go out forehead to forehead. What that allows me to do is to create some space in between me and my opponent where I can still have a good tie, a good tight tie up without being in here too tight to where if Chaney's a real strong guy, he can really bind me in it. It can be really difficult to find some positions and angles to score. So walking into our opponent, I'm going to walk in forehead to forehead, okay? Forehead to forehead, and generally when we get in, guys will tie up whether it be an inside tie, meaning on the inside of his arm, or an outside tie, being on the outside of his arm, here. So inside tie versus outside tie. What we use, at this point, what we use our hand fight is I want to be able to get this guy's hands off me. If I let Chaney hang on me and start pulling on me, it can really start to wear me out. Both of my cardio can get worn out because I'm constantly having to fight Chaney's hands off. And also it can really wear my neck out, which you see a lot of high caliber wrestlers and Division I, Division II college athletes really wearing guys out and beating on their head in order to find some space to score. Couple ways to get hands off or guys tied off of my body while maintaining my hands on. First one we'll go over is if Chaney has an inside tie. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and snap this arm. But generally, guys, if he's a good wrestler, he's just not gonna let me snap his arm off. It won't happen that way. It doesn't happen that easy. So one thing that I'll do is I'm gonna take an angle away from the side that he has a tie. So I'm gonna step away, and I'm gonna pull and snap the opposite direction of my step. So I'll step one angle and I'll snap away from me, going in the other direction. It looks like this here. Do my tie in. I'm gonna go ahead and get my hand in position. Guys, I'm positioning it right beneath this, or right next to his bicep here. And I'm not only gonna snap down, but I'm gonna pull down and away that way. At the same time, again, I'm gonna be taking a step in the opposite direction. So we'll tie up here. He ties, he's got a little tight tie. I'm gonna snap down and away and take a step in the opposite direction. Okay? That angle is really important because as I move into my offense, I'm creating an angle to where I can attack. So that's one way, stepping away and snapping in the opposite direction. Again, Chaney comes and ties up, and maybe I have an inside tie, and Chaney will go ahead and do the same thing. He's gonna snap away, so we'll drill that a couple times. Another way of getting hands off is by bumping an arm up. I'm gonna include a level change as I bump an arm up. So Chaney's gonna tie inside tie tight here, again on the forehead, and I'm gonna level change here, back stays straight, and a good squat with my legs, and simultaneously I'm gonna use my forearm to bump up. Now I might not be able to get away as far as him having a hand on me, but it's not pulling on me. And again, this will lead me into my singles and my doubles. So I might take a back step, and I'm gonna bump up his arm, and it allows me to get some space to where I can maybe snatch single, or maybe into my double or my high crotch. So it'll look like this. I might snap once away, it'll tie up again, and I bump up. Same time I'm coming into him, and it'll allow me to get into my attacks. Again, singles and doubles. And secondary is I'm gonna use both hands. Maybe a guy is really just pushing on me and leaning on me, and he's got a real tight tie. I'm gonna do the same thing as the first one. I'm gonna kind of take an angle and a step away, and I'm gonna come both hands down. Snapping both arms instead of one. Again, this helps me lead in my single legs and double lifts. So we'll come in, Chaney's pushing on me, he's really owning the tie. I'm gonna take a step back and snap when I'm talking. Okay? Thirdly, is just being able to hand fight, especially if the guy's got me in here and I don't feel comfortable. I'm gonna try and hand fight my opponent where I can change my head side to lead me into an attack. So this guy's got a real tight tie here, okay? I'm gonna be able to work my hand from outside position, inside position. You can either come around to change head sides, or I have to come underneath to change head sides. Also, again, simultaneously, being able to push and pull, snap those arms off me. So we'll come, Chaney's got a real tight tie. I might snap and bring my head to the opposite side. And now, at this point, I'm gonna go right into my very first level change and snap away. Okay? Here's how that'll look. We come in, he's wrestling. There, he's got an inside tie on this side here. I'm gonna step away and snap. There are just a few ways just to help you create some space, get a couple angles, and again, being able to take those guys' arms off. Last part here is while I'm hand fighting guys, I wanna make sure to keep my hand fight aggressive as I'm making sure to take his arms off. So what we'll do for about 10 seconds is we're gonna go up into some tie situations, and I'm gonna continue, and I'm gonna pull his head, and I'm gonna post, and I'm gonna be pulling him while maintaining his arm staying off me. So we'll do this for about 4 or 5 seconds. We'll come in, arm snapping, keeping his arms off me, moving, snapping, down. And what that does again, guys, is it wears a guy out. Moving into offense, I'll move around, I'll snap, his arms off there, space to attack. I'll go snap here, move in here, double, in. Just a couple things that might help you out. For more exercise and workout techniques, go to www.combatfitness.com.